Hello everyone, good evening and welcome to our webcast and conference call for the quarter ended 31st December 2019. This is the first call of the calendar year, so a very happy new year to all of you. Joining me today on the call is Mr. Piyush Gupta, our Group CFO, Mr. Sandeep Gulati, CFO of Hindustan Media Ventures Limited, Mr. Parvez Bajan, Group Controller, and my colleagues from the Investor Relations team. All of you would have had an opportunity to go through the financial results for Hindustan Media Ventures Limited and HT Media Limited. Our remarks today will track with the presentation on webcast, which is also available on the Investor Relations section of our website. Moving on to slide 2 of the presentation, I would like to draw your attention to the disclaimer regarding forward-looking statements, which is included in the presentation. Kindly keep this in mind. Moving on to slide 3, the slide 3 gives the chairperson's comments on the performance of the company, which mentions impact on ad spends due to a broad-based slowdown in the economy. As you would be aware, GDP growth for quarter 2, 19-20 was at 4.5, which is the slowest growth in the last 6 years. The IIP witnessed a decline of 4% in October and a mild growth of 1.8% in November. Advertisers have reacted to the slowdown in demand by keeping their discretionary spends in check, which has put pressure on our revenues. On the plus side, softer commodity and rates and our continuous focus on cost control has given us a good growth on operating profit and margins. We continue to be hopeful of recovery in ad spends as and when the broader economy revives. Moving on to the next slide, I will now hand over the call to Mr. Piyush Gupta to take you through the details of the financial performance for the quarter. After the remarks, the call will open for Q&A. Over to you, Piyush.
Thank you, Anna. Good afternoon, everyone, and a very happy new year to all the investors and the analysts. You know, I'll just quickly go over to the charts now on the consolidated performance on chart 6, if you were to just to see. Our total revenue came at 636 crores, which is a 5% decline. EBITDA, however, on the other hand, as my colleague just referred to, has shown a sharpish increase. You know, the better than last year commodity rates have a big role to play in that. And of course, as she had pointed out, you know, there are tight cost control measures in the company which are also yielding fruit. As a consequence, our margin jumps up by 6 points to 19%. PBT at 42 crores and PAT at 14 crores with a PAT margin of 2%. Net cash remains at 999 crores as of third quarter end. If we move forward to a business unit performance, and let's look at the print business unit first. So on the print business unit, our revenues are down by 52 crores, which is 12% decline, coming in at 379 crores. Circulation revenue at 69 are flat, so there's some commendable work which has happened on realization per copy, and better realizations have kicked in. Operating revenue as a consequence comes to 495 crores and operating EBITDA at 82 crores at a 17% margins. There are some key drivers given there. You know, margin expansion is on the back of softer raw material costs and very tight cost controls. There's a sequential growth in circulation revenue, which continues into this quarter, and we are hopeful that the direction will be maintained in quarters going forward. On the not-so-good side, the ad volumes have been muted, even as we are trying to hold on to the yields, and decline is visible across both national and local advertising. Moving forward into a little bit of detail on slide number 11, if we were to just analyze our English business, the revenues are down, ad revenues are down 15%, and circulation revenues are down 3%. Some of the big drivers on revenue have been sequential circulation revenue growth, which I just highlighted earlier. And in terms of various categories, government and BFSI witnessed double-digit growth in this particular quarter. Some of the negatives have been the ad volumes have struggled during the quarter. You know, so most categories which we track have been soft and have been declining. Softness in categories like e-commerce, auto, real estate, telecom, durable, and retail still continues, and declining national advertising is more pronounced than local advertising. Moving forward to the Hindi business, you know, we witnessed a 7% decline in our ad revenues, coming in at 153 crores, whereas circulation revenues remained flat. Growth in circulation revenues on sequential basis has been driven by improvement in realization per copy to the point that I had alluded earlier. And government and medical and health and fitness categories have witnessed growth. The ad spend softness in key categories have been auto, retail, durable, real estate and e-commerce. Moving forward to radio, we've had a decline of about 9%, we've had a growth of 9% on radio, but the growth is primarily driven by the consolidation of Radio One, the acquisition that we had done and started consolidating from 1st of April. Operating EBITDA, shows a decline of 35% and operating EBITDA margin at 24%. Again, the muted industry, has been one of the big reasons and some of the sectors which have not performed are FMCG, auto, travel and tourism. Growth in BFSI and real estate and education categories have been witnessed in this quarter, and we have managed to continue our good work on yields in this quarter, and our yields across all stations have improved. With this, I come to the end of the presentation, and we go into the Q&A section.